Redeemer lives. What hope this sweet assurance gives, that he who gave his life for me arose with healing in his wings. He lifts the tomb is empty still. Redemption's promise he fulfilled. No condemnation now remains. The stone of death is rolled away. My Redeemer lives. My Redeemer lives. On heaven's throne and in my very soul, I know that my Redeemer lives. I know that my Redeemer lives, and all my life is bound to his. In realms above he intercedes, our sinless Savior, perfect priest. No fear can follow where he guides. His constant presence is my light. No power on earth or heaven above can separate us from his love. My Redeemer lives. My Redeemer lives. On heaven's throne and in my very soul, my Redeemer lives. I know that my Redeemer lives. In life and death I trust in him. My soul secure, my future safe. He'll not forsake me to the grave. He lives and he will not delay. My eyes will wake to brightest day. And in my flesh I'll see him stand when Christ in glory comes again. And every eye will see him stand when Christ in glory comes again. My Redeemer lives. My Redeemer lives. On heaven's throne and in my very soul, I know that my Redeemer lives. My Redeemer lives. My Redeemer lives. On heaven.
all choirs of angels and saints in heaven before us. Now heaven and earth, even all of creation, rejoice, brothers and sisters in Jesus. One line we've been waiting to say for the past 6 weeks. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
This is a day which the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad.
Alleluia. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We cannot enter God's presence as we are. Our sinful condition falls short of the glory of God. Let's give voice to those sins, confessing our faults and our failures to each other, and of course, to God. Most merciful God, I confess that I am by nature sinful and unclean. I have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what I have done and by what I have left undone. I have not loved you with my whole heart. I have not loved my neighbors as myself. I justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on me. Forgive me, renew me, and lead me, so that I may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. The good news is this, my friends. Rejoice and be glad. God became one of us. Jesus, who died to pay for your sins. Jesus not only paid the penalty on this day our Heavenly Father proclaimed to all the world that he accepted the payment. Indeed, your sins are forgiven. In the stead and by the command of our risen Lord Jesus, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah! Christ is risen! My dear brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
And so together we pray. Heavenly Father, Lord of life, creator of all things, and by your mighty power, you raised your Son, our Savior, to life from death. We cannot fully understand this, but pray that you keep us ever mindful of this good news, so that we may live each day in triumphant gladness through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. And if all the young kids can come up, that would be fantastic. Y'all come up and, oh, noisy offering. You're pretty observant there, Michael. Sorry, I got an itch and I'm got it on top of the microphone. Sorry. Hey, guys. How you doing, Samantha?
Good.
How you doing?
Good.
Thumbs up? Okay. Did you have any peeps yet today?
No.
Oh, I had two packages already. Can you tell? Woo! Can you tell? Yeah. Do you like peeps? You love peeps? So do I. I got some in the back room there if you want some more peeps.
But I know one thing.
What's that?
You love M&M's.
Oh, I love M&M's. You know what I know what about you? You like gifts, right?
Yeah.
And your voice dropped, Samantha. I have a gift for you and everybody. It's a good thing y'all came up because I'm going to give you a gift. It's in this box, and I don't know why I'm singing. Too many peeps. You want to see what you got? Here's a gift from me to you. Here you go. This is for you guys.
It's empty.
What?
It's empty.
It's empty. Oh. Well, you can still use the box. Isn't it good? It's an empty grave? Hold that thought for 30 seconds. All right. It's an empty box. You can still use an empty box, right, Carlton? You can put things in here and you can carry it to school, right? Would you carry this to school?
Maybe.
Yeah, I didn't think so. All right. You can put your stuffed animals in here and your Legos, right?
Yeah.
So it's empty, but it's still kind of good, right? Yeah, but... Guys, I told you I'd give you a gift, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it's not a really good gift.
I know what the gift is.
You do?
Jesus, well, you can't see it. It's God. You can't see God.
Well, this is true, Michael. You're going to be a pastor. Oh! Listen! You hear that?
Easter eggs.
Easter eggs! I told you I got you a gift! Woo-woo! Here's a gift!
Hey.
Oh, take one! Take one! Woo! She's got two.
Just get two for
No, everyone. Just want to... Oh, hold on, there's people down there yet. Hold on.
I'm getting two for Carly.
Well, hold on. Carly, pass them out down there. I got tickets. Give them down there. You got some? Where's yours? Told you I gave you a gift. Here, take two you want. Take two.
There's still more.
There's still more. Take two. They're good. Ready? On the count of three, open up your gift.
Here, wait, I need one.
Oh, give Michael one. There he is, Michael. Ready? One, two, three.
Empty.
What?
Where's my other one? Oh, it's empty too.
They're all empty. Wait a minute. Empty eggs. Well, that's not really good, is it? But you know what? Empty is good. Because today, Jesus, you can keep it. You can keep
Jesus
it.
Jesus got, there was an empty tomb.
Empty tomb, that's right, Michael.
Empty tomb, empty egg.
Empty tomb, empty egg. And guess what? Remember last Sunday? We put our palm branches on the cross, and we turned the cross around to show Jesus on the cross. Today, when you go back to your seats, take a look at the cross, because Jesus, well, he's on this side, but on that side, the cross is empty. And I'll tell you what, when you go back to your seats, take a look at the cross, because you'll see four people on the cross, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, on the cross. The cross is empty. The tomb is empty. That means it's a good thing. Come on, tell me.
Jesus rose.
Jesus rose from the dead.
What's in this box?
Empty. So, wait. Just to show how things are happy because of empty, I'll tell you what. Samantha. Stand up and say loudly, Christ is risen. Watch this. Okay. Stand up. Go. Michael, stand up. Say, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen.
You too, stand up. Turn around. Tell them.
Christ is risen.
You three, stand up. Let them know. So empty is good, right? Today we celebrate the tomb being empty and the cross being empty, and that's a good thing because it means Jesus is alive. So this is a good thing. So you can take this home, and you know what? I did promise you a gift, didn't I? Yeah, I did promise you guys a gift. This box is not empty, but it comes with a deal. You got to make a deal with me. You make it, I got you right in the forehead, sorry. You are healed. There you go. Oh, you got that, thank you. I told you, too many peeps. Now, here's the deal, real serious. You may have this gift, but you have to listen to mom or dad or grandma and grandpa before you open this. Is that a deal?
Yes.
Thumbs up if it's a deal. Thank you, guys, okay. Look what I got. Hold on. You got to ask mom and dad before you can have one. You see, you should have come up, see? You should have come up, see?
My brother should have come up.
Your brother should have come up? Well, there's one for your brother.
We have two brothers.
You have two brothers? Are you sure?
There's four brothers.
You got four brothers? Okay. I got three more brothers. You won. You've got my little buddy down there.
I want one for my grandma. My grandma needs one.
Your grandma needs one?
Yeah, my grandma needs one.
Give this down to...
My grandma needs one.
All right.
I'll get one for my mom.
All right, let's pray. Let's pray. Let's pray. Let's thank God that empty today is a good thing. All right? So let's pray to God. Let's pray to God. Okay, ready? Hands up. One, two, three. Oh, God, thank you. And we can even stay up here and we can have fun because we know that you're alive. And that brings us so much joy. So thank you, Jesus, that the tomb is empty, that the cross is empty, and that just shows us how much you love us. So thank you, Jesus, that empty today is a good thing because it shows us that we have life in you. So thank you, Jesus, in you we pray, amen. Before you guys sit down, can you turn around on a face those guys on a count of three? Let's say it one more time. So stand up. Ready? One, two, three. Christ is risen. Hey, guys. Thanks for coming up, guys.
Can I get one
from No.
alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. Oh, 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 oh. Precious blood of Christ. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Our Old Testament reading comes from Isaiah 25, verses 6 through 9. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wine, of rich food full of marrow, of aged wine well refined. And he will swallow up on this mountain the covering that is cast over all people, the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. And the Lord God will wipe away tears from all the faces, and the reproach of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, behold, this is our God. We have waited for him, that he might save us. This is the Lord. We have waited for him. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. This is the word of the Lord.
Our epistle reading is from 1 Corinthians chapter 15. If in this only we have hoped in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For as by a man came death, by a man come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so also in Christ shall all be made alive, but each of his own order, Christ the firstfruits, then at his coming those who belong to Christ, then comes the end, when he delivers the kingdom to God the Father after destroying every rule and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. This is the word of the Lord.
Throughout the years, the Easter Gospel has been spoken in the midst of the people. And so we continue that church tradition. And so I invite you to please rise, if you are so able, as we hear the Easter Gospel this morning. And the Easter Gospel is, according to St. Mark, the 16th chapter. When the Sabbath was passed, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they could go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. And they were saying to each other, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" And looking up, they saw that the stone had been rolled back. It was very large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, dressed in a white robe. And they were alarmed. And he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has risen. He's not here. See the place where they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." And they went out and fled from the tomb, for trembling and astonishment had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, because they were afraid. This is the gospel of the Lord. Please be seated.
My fear.
us he lives. Amen. Amen. Let my song join the one that never ends. Amen. Amen. I'm alive because he lives. Amen. Amen. Let my song join the one that never ends because he lives. Because he
Amen, because he lives. He lives indeed, because this is Easter. Wow. The greatest day of the year, because it celebrates the greatest day in history. There's so much that you can say about Easter, and even a whole season of 50 days, which Easter is. Easter is a season of 50 days. It's all still too little of time to hold everything that we can say about Easter in. The entire Christian religion is based on our Lord's resurrection from the dead. And it's an inexhaustible source for doctrine and confession and life and celebration, because as you heard from the kids, the tomb is empty, the cross is empty, and it's all about being alive. And that's the Easter joy, and that's one reason why I love children's time, is we can just sit on the floor and have fun. Especially today, because it's today to have fun. Because it's Easter, and we know the reason behind the joy, that Jesus is alive. But why is it that so many people today misunderstand Easter? And so many people reduce it to a celebration of spring, or only as an opportunity for wearing new clothes and overindulging in chocolate, Peeps, and M&Ms. Not something I would do. Just the other day, I went to 6 stores asking where they keep the chocolate crosses for Easter. And you wouldn't believe the looks I got. Crosses? Yeah, it's Easter. And I left each store scratching my head and saying, don't they know what they're missing? After all, what would life be like without Easter? Think about it. Paul says, if Christ has not been raised, your faith is useless. Meaning, take away Easter. And we're no longer the first fruits of Christ's resurrection, but rather we are the leftovers of Satan's temptation and Adam and Eve's first sin. You take away Easter and you take away the forgiveness of sins, and because Easter tells us that Good Friday actually worked for us, that God had accepted the sacrifice of Jesus on our behalf. Take away Easter and you put everything back in place, everything bad. You put the devil back in charge, back in power, with his hold over you that's called sin. Well, you take away Easter and you take away life. You take away joy. Because death now becomes everybody's eternal destiny and not life. Adam read a moment ago from 1 Corinthians, if in Christ we have hope in this life only, we are of all people most to be pitied. Pitied. You take away Easter and you take away the glorified body, described in 1 Corinthians 15 as the cornerstone of our hope not only life forever, but one so glorious that we can hardly imagine what it's like. Hence the power behind the marvelous Mercy Me song, I Can Only Imagine. But the resurrection of the body, even the first Christians just couldn't quite get it. Couldn't quite get it. How can this be, they asked. When you're dead, you're dead, is what those Corinthians were saying. And we said, well, it sure does look that way. It sure does look that way. Because common sense tells us that dead people don't typically come back to life here on earth. That reality is not a zombie movie with the dead walking again around the earth. Here and now, on this side of heaven, life always ends in death. Fight it, deny it, ignore it, choose whatever you want to use as a strategy, it doesn't really matter. Death always wins. It happens to everyone. It's final. On this side of heaven, when you're dead, you're dead. Or so it seems. And that's where Easter comes in. You see, Easter turns all that around, right? But now, in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. You see, today is all about Jesus rising from the dead. He lives, and because he lives, you too will live. We shall live with a glorified body. For as in Adam all die, so also in Christ shall all be made alive. A glorified body is ours. Because life doesn't end in death for us. It's only the beginning. We have life with Jesus forever. And that's why those Corinthians were so skeptical. It was hard for them to imagine breathing new life into a dead corpse. They couldn't get it. A second death? What's all that about? It was difficult for them to get it. So Paul writes, so it is with the resurrection of the dead. What is sown is perishable. What is raised is imperishable. It's sown in dishonor. It's raised in glory. It's sown in weakness. It's raised in power. Powerful stuff from Paul. Perishable, dishonor, weakness. That's us, folks. That's our experience of body and life. That's us. And since we know no other way, we're used to this reality about our bodies. And in spite of all their frailties, we tend to like our bodies. We love our bodies. And in fact, let's be honest, we don't just live in our bodies, we are our bodies. And they're us. But God tells us that we're going to get a glorified body, a sinless body, because Jesus lives. He rose again and he lives forever. And that's what those Corinthians just couldn't quite understand. And that's a great message to hear on Easter. That these bodies will be changed into a glorified body. On earth, we deal with things like cancer and illnesses and diseases. We deal with things like dementia and Alzheimer's and memory loss. We deal with things like liver diseases and amputation because of diseases stemming from diabetes. And we just scratch our heads. But then we come to his glorious sanctuary and hear the Easter message. That's for us. That because Jesus lives, because the tomb is empty, because the cross is empty, it means new life for us. And new life for us means that we will get that new body. In spite of everything that goes on, we know what Paul meant over 2,000 years ago, that our bodies, although they get old and they wear out and they die, that last enemy that Paul talks about, death, is gone forever. It's gone forever. Because we are alive. Alive in Jesus. And that's what Easter is all about. Being alive. And think about it. As I shared with the kids, so often empty means something not good. Imagine if you opened your Christmas gift on Christmas morning. You were joyful, excited, and you opened your Christmas gift, a big old box, beautiful paper, beautiful bows on top of it, and you're tearing the bows off, you're tearing the paper off, and you look inside the big box, and it's empty. I'll never forget one Christmas. I was probably Lauren's age. There's a box under the tree with my name on it. Beautiful box. Great box. I opened it up excitedly. And inside, there was nothing. It was empty. And the gift giver thought it was funny. I never did. And 50 years later, that story is still fresh in my mind. I remember that day like it was yesterday. Because back then, nothing or empty brought me great sadness. Until I realized that the Easter message is for me, and it's for you too. That the cross being empty and the tomb being empty really is all something to be joyful about. That Jesus showed his love for me. It wasn't a joke. It was love. It was love that brought Jesus to the cross. It was love that took Jesus to the tomb, a borrowed tomb, in fact. And it was love that God, his Father, raised him from the dead. So for us, empty, nothing, is a good thing. And that's why we rejoice. But you know what? There's a whole world out there, a whole society out there that doesn't think the same way we do. Oh, a lot of them do, yes, granted. But there's a good percentage of those people out there who don't feel the same joy we do, who think today is just another day, that these next 50 days is just springtime. And they fail to see the goodness of today. So it's up to us. It's up to us to share the story, especially to those people who are hurting. And you know them as well as I do. You know the people in your circle of friends, in your family, who need to hear that Easter gospel, the good news, that life is not empty, that life is not nothing, but that Jesus loved them all the way to an empty cross and an empty tomb. It's all about life. And that's why we can celebrate. We can raise our voices and we can celebrate. And indeed, today, for the next 50 days, and the next, whatever, 200 and some odd days, we can say that Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. In the wonderful name of our God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. And now may the peace of God that goes far above a human understanding, may it keep all our hearts and all our minds in the love of an alive, risen Savior Jesus Christ. It's in him that we pray and praise. Amen. It is with joy that we profess not only to ourselves and to each other, but to the world that we believe in a loving God. And so I invite you to please rise and join me as we profess our common faith. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence you will come to judge the living and the dead. What does this mean? I believe that Jesus Christ, true God, begotten of the Father from eternity, and also true man, born of the Virgin Mary, is my Lord, who has redeemed me, a lost and condemned person, purchased and won me from all sins, from death, and from the power of the devil. When I with gold or silver, but with his holy, precious blood, and with his innocent suffering and death, that I may be his own and live unto him in his kingdom, and serve him in everlasting righteousness, innocence, and blessedness, just as he is risen from the dead, lives and reigns to all eternity. This is most certainly true. Please be seated as we gather the gifts of God. We rise for prayer. And we pray for the whole Christian church throughout the world, that it may be found without fault at the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for all believers in Jesus, that their lives may testify to his resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for all those in all levels of government, that they may serve justice and promote the welfare and dignity of every person. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for all who need our prayers and raise them up before God. And we pray, dear Lord, for the family and friends of Adele Woolman and the family and friends of Judy Speakman, to be with both families as they now grieve the loss of a loved one. We pray that even on this Easter morning, as they grieve and their hearts are sad and tears flow from their eyes, that they remember the joy of the resurrection and life everlasting. We pray also, dear Lord, for Chris Coma and Wade Frauhiger, for Tori Brinkerhoff and Barb Barnett, for Mick Elmer, Joe Streeter, for Dennis Brannick, for Shirley Hardesty in Brecken, for Avonlea Brannick and Tom Woolman, for Robin King, And all we name in our hearts before you, dear Lord. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray, dear Lord, for all who come to your table this morning to feast on your body and blood. We thank you, dear Lord, for the gifts of forgiveness of sins, life, and salvation which you bestow upon us in this wonderful sacrament. Help us to prepare our hearts, our minds, and our lives to worthily receive your sacrament. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And so, Father, into your hands we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy and your love. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. On the same night when our Lord was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to his disciples and he said, "Take and eat, for this is my body which is given just for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, in the same way, he took the cup after supper, and once again, when he had given thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and drink of it, all of you, for this is my blood which is shed for you for the forgiveness of all of your sins. Do this in remembrance of me." And so as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Jesus, remember us in your kingdom and teach us always to pray, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you. Jesus died, my soul to save, shall rend the vaulted skies. Selflessness and peace, my fate was surely sealed until he rescued me. His pardon for my sin, his bounty for my need, from slavery and shame I am redeemed. And heaven can't contain the glory of the Son.
Rise for God's benediction and a powerful last Easter hymn this morning. I first want to give a quick thank you, and I know hopefully I don't forget anybody, and I know a lot of people to say thank you at the first service this morning, but a huge thank you to so many people, not only during Lent, but during Holy Week, and especially Monday, Thursday, Good Friday, and of course Easter morning. And again, I'm not going to name names because I'll forget somebody, and I don't want to do that. But a huge thank you to everybody who had a hand during this Lent, Holy Week, and especially this morning. We could not have done it without you. We are a team. But more importantly, we are a family of God. A family of God that can say, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Hallelujah. Let's rise and hear God's benediction and then sing one of the most powerful Easter hymns of all time. But first, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you in favor and may always bless you with his Easter love. Amen.
can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel when I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? Or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I can only imagine, yeah. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? Or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine. Forever worship you.